वेलकम बैक। डॉक्टर पी पेरुमल इज प्रेजेंटली कंजर्वेटर ऑफ सरस्वती महल लाइब्रेरी इन तंजौर तमिलनाडु। सरस्वती महल लाइब्रेरी इज वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट लाइब्रेरीज इन एशिया एंड हैज़ ऑन डिस्प्ले रेयर कलेक्शन ऑफ पाम लीफ मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट्स। अ म्यूजियम इज ऑल्सो लोकेटेड इन द सरस्वती महल लाइब्रेरी सरस्वती महल लाइब्रेरी बिल्डिंग टू रिवील द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ द लाइब्रेरी टू द पब्लिक। दिस म्यूजियम इज वेल ऑर्गेनाइज्ड इनटू सेक्शंस हाईलाइटिंग एंशियंट मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट्स, इल्यूस्ट्रेटेड मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट्स, प्रिंटेड कॉपीज ऑफ ओरिजिनल ड्राइंग्स, कैनवास पेंटिंग, ग्लास पेंटिंग, पोर्ट्रेट्स ऑफ तंजौर महाराजा किंग एंड फिजियोग्नॉमी चार्ट्स ऑफ चार्ल्स लीबग्रून। डॉक्टर पी पेरुमल इज एक्सपर्ट ऑन हाउ टू प्रिजर्व एंशियंट पाम लीफ मैन्युस्क्रिप्ट्स, वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ देयर ओरिजिन, यूजेज एंड कंजर्वेशन। I would like to invite now Dr. P. Perumal to give a talk on preserving Indian literary tradition.
Thank you for giving this opportunity. With the blessing of Swamiji's, I wish to share my experience. I am not a well-knowledgeable person like Dan, you know, but I have the library for the last 32 years, so I am here to share my experience, how to preserve the books and what are the importance in the library. So, you know, Tanjavur is one of the ancient place. For the last 1200 years, it is a headquarter of the Cholas and Nayaks, Cholas, Pandyas, Nayaks, and later Marathas. So even now, we have the continue traditions of the things. Because everywhere in India, most of the civilization formed on the bank of river only. So the Tanjore civilization, we can say the Cauvery is the another important thing. Because due to the Cauvery, we have the long traditions of the literary traditions. And we have in Tamil Nadu, most of the, just we can equal into Ajanta, we have the paintings and other things also. Next. You can see this, whenever we mention the name Tanjavur, our mind we have, the temple will come. It's one of the 1000 years old temple. Just when you are seeing the Tanjavur, there is no hill or mountain, but this was, the temple was completely built with the stone. But just imagine there is no mortar and other things. It was completely interlocking, stone interlocking things. And that way, it's a 216 feet height, and the last but one was one of the single stone, it's 80 ton, it's mentioning. How, without any engineering, present engineering technique, they brought to them. Next. This, the Chola, he was very much interested in documentation. The Rajaraja Chola, he has completely documented, and his administration, all other things also. In the whole temple, you can find that inscription form of it. So that gives complete history of Rajaraja Chola. So in India, in Tamil Nadu particularly, South Indian inscriptions of volume 2, there are some 5 parts gives complete translation of this South Indian inscription. Next. You could find that massive things, how they have, whether they have carved and they have put it, or they have put the stone then carved. So in that way, this is most of the massive, it's a 16 feet height and a single stone of Dwarapalakasa in the entrance of the tower. So they have just put that stone, then they have carved it. So it's like that, everything they have, some of the historians telling that mostly they put that stone, they filled with the sand, then the other stone. So they carved from the top to bottom. So that way they have done it. Next. So next to Ajanta, there is a 10th century painting. That is a painting, also the fresco type of painting. It's a very important, very as a fresco type painting, because the total the tower was supported with the two wall. The inner wall is 11 feet, outer wall is 13 feet. That 13 feet wall, inside that wall, they have done the painting. That's why even nowadays it's in a good condition. Next. So nowadays we have that musician, there is a dance pose, 118 dance poses, but 82 dance poses was carved in the stone itself. Next. Next. Tanjore is not only that type of things, painting also. Even all over the world nowadays, Tanjore painting. So this is one of the type of Tanjore painting. This is a view of Maratha Darbar Hall. Next. So that literary traditions, we can say there is in literature that the human knowledge is recorded in various format. So the first format of the sharing of the recording the format is stone. The stone was the first format. But actually we cannot move the stone from one place to other. So they have people, they have find other materials. Next. So bricks used as a thing. Then metal sheets. Metal sheets, all type of metals they have used, gold, silver, and copper, and even other iron also they have used. Because most of the things for carving stone, brick and metal, it needs some skills. So they just search some soft materials. And soft materials, plant-based materials and animal-based materials they have searched. The plant-based material means a tree, just whatever from the bottom onwards, the leaves of the tree, bark of the tree and wooden planks like that they have used in it. And animal-based, the skin, the leather, the vellum, parchment, these are used as a thing. Next. You can see there is bone was also used, cloth was used and paper was prepared. It is telling there is a paper was prepared in 105 AD by China, but there is a contrary also. The first paper was invented in India in 300 BC. When Alexander came to India, there is one Nirkus, there is a scientist, sorry, an archaeologist who accompanied with him. Just he mentioned that India was used cotton-based plates that was called paper those days. Mostly the cotton-based paper was written here. That was proved by the handmade paper industries scientists, one of the Goswami has done a doctorate and all this. So now, even though we are claiming that literally we are having paper is one of the ancient material in India, but we don't have any evidence to show. That's why the Chinese claim that the first country who invented paper. Next. So these things, the stone and all these things are very rare. Later days, one of the clay tablets. So in the ancient days, mostly the pictorial letters were used in those days. Next. Stone was important, but this is a particular stone, Rosetta Stone. It has an information in three script, which were the... And that was the papyrus. Egypt, most of the ancient writing material was papyrus. Next. The bottom was Bhurjapatra, that is in India there is two material was used for writing, even nowadays we are getting the manuscripts. There is a bridge bark, it's called Tamil Bhurjapatra, and another one is a palm leaf. Next. In south, there is eastern part of the world, there is mostly, they use the bamboo as a writing material. Korea and Japan, all these things are bamboo, and wooden planks also they have used it. Next. So, the palm leaf was one of the writing material which was used for writing. The palm leaf, there is three varieties of palm leaf was used. And mostly there is one is called Thalipat palm. It is in Tamil it is called as Kundal Panai. Another one is called Palmera palm. Then third one is a Londar palm. The earliest Mahabharata and Ramayana were written with Thalipat palm, because it is in a very lengthy and wide, so they have written on the things. But later days, nowadays, palmera is mostly used for writing material. And the technique also, there is a two type of technique in India. In North India, they are written with ink only. In South India, is an engraving technique. So the North Indians, because they use the papyrus, the bridge bark, then palm leaf also used some of the area in Bengal and other places. They have used it written with ink only. Next. So these are the three varieties of palm leaf mostly. The palmera is mostly different length and breadth we can find in different areas according to the fertility of the land and some of the water fertility. The londar is mostly available in Ceylon and Thailand and Burma only. That is the quality of these both things. It's a very lengthy, very wide and thickness also. Next. So this is a Kundal Panai, that is a Sritala manuscripts. But actually the life is 70 years. Whenever there is a damage, only another there is a shaft came from bottom itself. That is the Palmera manuscripts. Next. For writing the manuscripts, they cannot select the manuscript leaf as it is. They have selected not the bottom, not the top. They selected the middle-aged leaf. because the bottom is more hard and the middle, the top is more tender. They select the middle-aged leaf and they separate it. They separate and put it in between a plank. After drying, after a shadow drying, they cut the edges. Then they divided the whole leaf 7 parts. From the end, from this end, the 2 parts, from this end, they 2 parts make holes. After making holes only, they have removed that rib, because till that it is a twin leaf. After that, remove the rib, then they burnish with some soft stone. When they are burnishing, the leaf must be, the juice in the leaf will be spread on, so it will give flexibility. When the leaf is flexible, they are kept in their house. Before writing, I told the writing is two types of, the writing is, before writing, they have to season the leaf. They season the leaf means they have to put it in the steam bath, or put it in the sand, wet sand, or frequent application of the oil, or all other, so put it in the some milk, boiling with the milk. All these things make the surface is very soft. When the surface is soft, they have engrave it on the like thing. So that is the way they have used. After engraving, they have to blackening. Blackening, just because at the time of writing they are not using any blackness. So this is just they put it in some other dadura leaf with a lamp suit, or cosina indica, in Tamil we call it a kova ilai. There is a cosina indica and this lamp suit. And manuscripts they have written for two purposes. One is just in every house some of the manuscripts must be kept. So then only the children will get good education. That's why most of the manuscripts, Ramayana, Mahabharata are manuscripts, they written, they apply only turmeric paste only and they put it in the puja room. But what are the manuscripts for reading, they have done it the blackness. So then the binding technique also very strict. So they want to use a selective round form of the thread. And if it is a manuscript, is more than 300 leaves or 100 leaves, they put a bamboo strip on another hole also. So in this type of careness they have taken for binding the manuscripts. Next. You can see the how they are using. The writing is not in we can just like a paint pencil writing. So they have used both the hand. This hand, most of them, even Thiruvalluvar, you can find that he's called the stylus in this form only. This stylus will rest in this nail. Yes, they cut a small V cut in this nail. So this will rest in the nail. So the upper hand will give pressure, and the bottom, they hold these things in this way. And this is their way of scratching and the thing. So that is the way they have scratched it. So after scratching, at the time of scratching, they won't do anything. Then after that only they use it. The bottom they can find that is the sticks are they called narasams. And even the tying technique they use from one end to other end, then it comes repeated. It's such a uniform pressure they will give that in the manuscripts. Next. These are the stylus used in those days. That last is called a common stylus used in everybody and every person. The middle, the stylus used for the children's, because it has it has some weight on the center. So the children's cannot give much pressure. That is, this is called a folding stylus. Folding stylus. A person can fold it and keep it in pocket. So in Tamil we call this madakaluthane. So just minus this stylus, nowadays we are called pen knife. The pen knife means a knife with a pen in those days, but nowadays without a pen also we call this a pen knife. It's a folded pen knife, we are calling it a pen knife because of that only. Next. So we have a tradition of writing of manuscripts. Still we have 3000 years. Because in Sanskrit, there is a Paninium is the earliest grammar is we are having. Like that in Tamil, we have the 7th century BC, we have the Tulkapim is the earliest work is available. So a grammar is in 7th century and 10th century. Just you know the what was the language, it was there. So grammar when we are climbing, just when we are, we need a grammar, when the language is more literature is when coming, just to correct that literature only, we need a grammar. So in that way, we have the languages from at least some 5,000 to 6,000 years, even 10,000 years before. But we have, due to the climate condition, because India is a tropical climate, we are not preserving a palm leaf more than 500 years. So there is a damage. Whenever there is a damage, our tradition, we are rewriting of the palm leaf. Whenever there is a damage, they make a copy of the manuscripts. So we are having a copy suddenly. Even Ramayana is, we don't know when the Ramayana was started, but still we are having the Ramayana. We have the Mahabharata, still we are having the Mahabharata. Even Thirukkural was written in 2000 years back. We have Thirukkural. But the, all these things, whenever a damage is there, immediately make a copy. So the, all the things, all the manuscript tradition is due to the copiness also. Because the copiers, they have written and completely we are having it in that copies only. But original manuscripts means whatever the available original manuscript, it must be written after 15th to 16th century. That is only the previous is only copy only. So in the whole India, we are having the whole world, the earliest palm leaf which is available is 2nd century BC, sorry, 2nd century AD, that is bottom things. Now, previously it was stored, it's in a Skanda Prana in Sanskrit language, it was kept in China and Turfan as a cave, but now it is in German only. That is the piece of that that manuscript is available. After that, we have the 4th century manuscript in Japan, and 7th century manuscript, even again, it was from Nepal to German only, it's available. And whatever the manuscripts available in India is only after 11th century only. Even 11th century, we can say one or two manuscripts only, you cannot say that. So the earliest, most of the manuscripts we have in different places they get stored. This is in the upper part, you can find there is in the earliest writing, stone images of writing of manuscripts. It is in a in Andhra Pradesh, Gundu, near Gundu, there is a Nagarjuna, that image is available. The Nagarjuna was the earliest university also there. That is the 2nd century AD, there was a university, Nagarjuna. It was a good library also, the manuscript library. But that was after that we have a library in the 6th century at Nalanda. Nalanda, because Michael sold some of the pictures. So Yuan Shuang and other, all the Chinese, they have taken some of the manuscripts from there. Means they have copied. We cannot say that all the manuscripts they have not taken. Yes, they have copied the manuscript. India, most of the foreigners, they came from for India, means for the spices and the literary traditions only. So they have came, they have most of the manuscripts taken out. But the, after 6th century, we have a little gap. And most of the manuscripts, they have came along with the religious base only. And they're completely religious. But only thing is, just I differ with Michael Mintz, just the war of religious war was, there is no religious war. But in Madurai, there was a religious war was there. In Madurai, there's Jain and Saiva manuscripts is there. So most of the Jainist manuscripts are destroyed because of the religious war only. Otherwise, we have a lot of things also. So that 10th century, you could find there is a lot of manuscripts are stored in the temples. Particularly, you can find in Kalugamalai temple, and Madurai temple, and Srirangam temple, Thanjavur temple, and Chidambaram temple. All these temples have inscription about the library, and the library name of the library, what are the lands given to the maintain the library, how much amount they have given, all these things they have maintained. And this was called as every temple, there was a separate room for storing of the manuscripts. It's called Thirukkaikoti. The room was completely covered with stone only. Thirukkaikoti, completely covered with stone only. And the priest was the librarian in those days. The priest, every important days, they had taken the manuscripts, they read. So the people assembling were hear it. So this type of things, every year there is a mandapam is called, it is called as Pattana Mandapam. In ancient days, mostly all these places is Pattana Mandapam. All the manuscripts stored it. Next. Even then where the manuscripts stored in the house. The house, because most of the houses were in huts. So they found this a proper place is the kitchen. Kitchen was the proper place to store the manuscripts. So they have put a loft over the kitchen to keep the manuscripts. So because they have received good rain, because of the rain, most of the fungus, it will affect the manuscripts. To protect from fungus, they found that the kitchen was the proper place. So they kept the manuscripts there and they allowed to deposit the smoke. When a manuscript has deposited smoke, it won't absorb the moisture. It won't, there's no insect will come. That was they put it in the loft only. And whatever they have practiced, every system of in our culture has some scientific background and religious background also. Every year, at least two times, they have to tag the manuscript, to touch the manuscript. Touch the manuscript means clean the manuscript. Because that is before rainy season and after rainy season. before rainy season, they put a day, Saraswati Puja. The Saraswati Puja is not to pray the manuscripts, just to clean the manuscript. If you are not cleaning the manuscript on Saraswati that day, that the dust will absorb the moisture, and the moisture will create some problem, it that insect will affect. So that's why that before the days, they had, even nowadays, if you are not to clean the manuscripts, books, even before rainy season, certainly that will be happen. So that is the day to clean the manuscript, we had to do. Then after rainy season, there is a reading practice. In most of the, in South India, you can find that in southern Tamil Nadu, in Karaikudi and other place, there is a, in a month of March, February and March, they will read the manuscripts. So this reading means it is called a aeration. Just it's a aeration. If more moisture will be go out. And if you have some one or two manuscripts, we have a plank and a hang in the beam of the kitchen only. So even the school going people, they hold it in the back. It is called Thuku. So we can say there is a, some of the rich people, they appoint some persons to hold these things. So those persons called Thuku Thuki. So they keep in the back. So this is a way. You can find this a very earlier picture of that one. Next. Most of the manuscripts deteriorated because of these three factors, physical factors and the biological, is now classified as according to the scientific way. But actually, basically, in those years, how they have classified means they are not classified. They have found there is a four factors: dust, light, heat, humidity. If you control these four things, there will not be any fungus. If there is no fungus, no insect. That was the thing. Those, so they have protected from that things, because first they have used there. And next, little after sometimes, they put it in the plank, it's a wooden plank. For wooden plank also, they have selected a good wood, it's a teak wood, or camphor wood they have used. As a camphor itself, we can keep away the insects. So they have put the manuscript in camphor wood, not as it is. They wrap the manuscript with some of the cloth. They have used it, because when they are using the cloth will protect the dust, the cloth will protect the light, heat and humidity. So they use the cloth. The cloth also, particularly they use silk cloth, because most of the insect won't come for silk. That is the, even cotton cloth, red color cotton cloth they use, because red is a repellent to insect. When we wrap anything with red color, no insect will come. That is the reason most of the temple nowadays, you can find the outer wall is white and red, because the red won't even. In the month of January, every house in South India, you put a red line in front of the house, because we have received the good rain in the previous months. So the micro insects from the cabbages, they travel towards the house. To avoid that only, they put a red line. And even to feed the insects, they put a rice flower design in front of the house. The insect will come and eat will return. So that is a scientific reason to avoid the insect things. So we have everything, we have a scientific background, all these things. Next. So later days, mostly plank, there is nowadays, manuscripts are kept with the, some of the boxes, wooden boxes, and even the cardboard boxes we are keeping it. And this is the way we are keeping it. So the importance of the manuscripts, just imagine, we have scientific approaches in those days, even our forefathers, they have, they put that every god and goddess's hand as a manuscript, give the importance of the things. Even the high graver, you have a manuscript. Saraswati, you have manuscripts. So like that, because if they have a manuscript in the god, they will give proper importance to them. Like that only to protect the trees, the mangrove. Every temple they have the mangrove. Every vahanas of the, some of the gods will have some animals to protect them only. These are the way they say, because more illiterate people say, they will know to protect this. And also to protect the, when we are seeing the live, the, even the temple itself, if I control, we can room in this room, we can control by air conditioner some way. So this is called microclimate control. But if you want to control a temple, because temple is made up of some other stone or even the mortar, and to protect the temple and other things, they have to have a macro control system. The macro control system, nowadays we are talking within a scientifically, there is a macro control like that. But ancient days, what they have done? Every temple must have a tank. Every temple must have a tank on the eastern corner, because that temple, that type of things, When the rain was there, automatically the water flowed to the tank only. It went down the ground. So if it goes down the ground, there may be some soil looseness that may affect the temple structure. So if water flows to the tank, there will not be things. And another thing, whenever in the summer, this most of the material, you release the moisture. Because of the expansion of air, the moisture will release the moisture. If any material release the moisture, it will contract. The contracts makes that stone weathering or powdering or crack. To avoid that only, from the tank, the water will evaporate. And to purify that area, that mangrove, that is in a stala vriksha. Every stala vriksha is wherever the trees grows in that area, they put it in. So every things have some system in our religious system is affected, admitted in the ancient days. But the only thing is, nothing was written, completely not documented, but later days it was damaged. Next. So this is one of the important manuscript in our library. It's called Valmiki Ramayana. It's one of the Sridhala manuscripts. Each page consists of 28 to 32 lines. Just imagine, without a magnifying place, they have written this. Next. They have taken a care for handling the manuscripts. Everything they have systematically. So the because of manuscripts, we have to book support. Even a book, we should not open a book more than 90 degree. But now we are opening it more than 20 degree. Then every house in those days there may be a book support just like. Why? Just we keep in the book must be 90 degree only. It protects the binding. It protects the binding. Even when you are sitting in the floor, without eye strain, we can read it. So there is a system. That is the thing. So this is a manuscript support. You can see this. And this is most of the manuscript itself in Kerala, they applied the redness to the manuscript leaf itself. So this is in Kerala, it's a traditional things also. And in the library, we are having, we had a pundit, sorry, a librarian, a worker in 1882, he prepared a separate ingredient for the insect repellent. So now in every house, everywhere, if any insect is there, we put it in a naphthalene balls and other things. Naphthalene balls is a chemical, you know chemical, it's a naphtha. So if we use it one time, the next time when you're using, no insect will die. Because the insect will get immunity. So we have to change our system. We have our forefathers. They have a different type of materials. Is there? They have scientifically. They have proof. So they have here we can see in Tamil, soodam, vasambu, karinjeerakam, milagu, krambu. So they have used camphor. And vasambu means it's in Tamil. It's in English called sweet flag. It's across column as in scientific name, gorabaksha in Hindi. And you know karinjeerakam, that is another kali mirch, kali jeera and black pepper and cloves. These materials was dried in the shadow and make it powder and put it in a small cloth with the camphor. That will be keep away the insects 6 months. But we should not do a particular thing for continuously because the insect will get immunity. So that's why we have to change before rainy season on or after rainy season on. If we are keeping this way, certainly we can at least twice in a year you have to tack out and you open the book before and raining and after raining and like that. So that is why you see then in the month of Markali here, there is in January. Most of the people, they throw the manuscripts in the fire. Why they are throwing fire? Yes, we call this a bogi. Bogi means we have to throw the old things. But why? Because the manuscripts, they are not touched the manuscript before rainy season. When they are due to the fungus, it was affected with the insect. So immediately they make a copy. And the copy, after copying, the insect should not spread to other manuscripts. So they had throw it to fire. That was the thing. In summer, if you are due to that dryness, if a manuscript is broken, so that was also they can make a copy, and the broken things should not fall in for the outside, so they put it in water. So these are the two practices after copying, they have to throw in the damaged things. But without knowing things, most of the our traditional, we lost the people, they have thrown it fire and thrown it water without copying. That is also them. Next. So in the library we are having the manuscripts. Every manuscript we have to separately, we have to arrange it. Next. So even now we are getting manuscript from other places. People are not knowing the important things of the things. Because the government of India in 2003, there was a project in our former Prime Minister Vajpayee has introduced as a National Mission for Manuscripts. The National Mission for Manuscripts was one of the important projects. It gives an opportunity to survey the manuscript wherever and whoever having the manuscript, and it has a database, and it's not completed, but it's going on. But when we completed the manuscript, we know the wealth of India, how many manuscripts are there, and what are the important manuscripts are there. All these things, we could know the things. So in that way, I was a coordinator of that project in Southern District. I have visited different parts of district, and I found the, and I collected the manuscripts. Because some of the people, they're having it, but they do not know to whom we have to hand it over, and like that. But this way, even we have conducted some of the workshops nearby there, and to preserve these manuscripts, and to give the importance of the manuscripts. So the people there, and then only they are giving the manuscript to us. Even nowadays, we are getting the manuscript from different part of Tamil Nadu also. And we are preserving, and we are giving. Some people, so they are not interested to give the manuscript. And that through the project, we went there, and we have preserved the manuscripts also. And by this way, we know, is any manuscript. Ramayana means we have 1,000 Ramayana. Mahabharata means we have 1,000. But any, some of the manuscripts have so unique. That manuscript must be make copy, because if he is not interested to give the manuscript, at least we can make him a copy and we keep preserve some other thing. So that means it should not be. We can see in our library also some of the manuscripts, very unique manuscripts are there. There is a manuscript called Bijapallavam. Bijapallavam is this, actually it is in a general algebra. Nowadays, what is algebra? It was in Bijapallavam in Sanskrit language. So we brought out in a book form also. Water divining. Wherever we will get that water position. So that is the manuscripts are there. And there is another important manuscript called Gadatreya. Gadatreya is one of the manuscript. When read from this side, it will give Ramayana. And this side, Bhagavata. Just grouping of words. So just imagine how they have written these things. These type of manuscripts available in our library. Next. So you have the most of our book enemies are these things. So actually the first thing is called a sugar loaf, sugar fish, and silver fish, sugar moth, all these things. So this is the monitoring insect, we can say. Whenever when you are locking the hall room after 4 or 5 days, when you are entering, you will have a filthy smell. And immediately you go, just you turn the page of, turn the back of your calendar, you could find that things. This is a solar fish. It will come to eat your material when it has some very soft and surface is soft. So, but it has no teeth, but it has scratches on the thing. So, most of the photographic was scratched by this solar fish only. And then the dangerous is the second one, that is bookworm. The bookworm. Bookworm is a larvae of more than 300 insects. Actually, whenever there is a filthy smell, due to that fungus, it's a filthy smell, the insects will come and eat the fungus and it will lay the eggs. When the eggs it hatch and it will penetrate that inside. When it is it grows as an insect, it will again, it will lay and it will go out. So it is a continuous process. If you are keeping a book, if you are not touching at least 2 years, if you are not touching at least 2 years, certainly you will have some bores in your book, because it is very difficult to find that also. But it is very easy to kill it, because if you have opened it, automatically the change of climate it will control it. There is no need of any chemical or other things. If you know the things, you go near the window or some just put a bulb, near the bulb you can turn the pages, automatically it will kill. Automatically the larva will kill by the change of climate. The other one is called lice, book lice. Book lice is nothing but if we were giving a book for the binding purpose, but it has not properly dried and you have given, you keep it as it is. And near the end of the, when you are folding the, near the end of that book and the outer cover, there may be the fungus growth. That was eaten by the bookworm. The another thing, dangerous is that cockroach. Cockroach come in the house, only two places, one is in the kitchen and other one is the toilet. So if you have any, just the food, when you are reading a book with a tea or something like that, some of the food shops, and you are touching the book and the touching the bag, automatically next day the cockroach will come and it will eat only. So cockroach won't come from any dried material, cockroach won't come. Because one of the eatable things is there, and oiliness and something like that, then a cockroach will come. So the last one is termite. You know the termite is very dangerous. But in our peoples, our forefathers were very clever. So because to avoid termite only, in those days, every house must be 3 feet higher than that ground level. If you built a house 3 feet higher than the ground level, no termite will affect. Because termite will come whenever there's the moisture is coming up. So the capillary action will come only 3 feet. It won't go more than 3 feet. So there will not be any problem. But nowadays, due to that, without knowing, we are building a hall or another things in the ground level. So we are having this things. But that is dangerous. It is as a queen, king, soldier, and workers, it may control, it will completely destroy a cupboard within a week. So that type of capacity there. But if we have, but moisture control, if you have a moisture control, we can control. So these are the things were dangerous. Most of our literary traditions are deteriorated with things. So even, you know, in 10th century, Rajaraja Chola, you might have that story, that is Nambi and Nambi was searching that Devara, that is in Saiva Devara manuscripts. And one Pulla player is giving that in a dream. All the manuscripts are stored in the Chidambaram temple. So that, with the help of Rajaraja, and they went and they have seen all the manuscripts with the heaps of this termite heap. And immediately there was saying that it's some sound has come. So whatever is not useful to this age, completely destroyed by the insect, and you can take other things. So they poured gingerly oil over the things. So through that incident, we know that the gingerly oil was the first material used to preserve the manuscripts. So they pour the gingerly oil over it and they clean it, and after that only now we are having that Devara manuscripts. Next. Like that, we have the paper manuscripts also from that. So, you know, I have already told that paper has a history. And papers, generally, we are handling the paper, but the paper is a different type of materials, raw materials. According to the raw materials, we can classify it four things. It is a cotton-based, and a bast-based, and a grass-based, and a wooden-based, wooden pulp-based. So, wooden pulp-based is very dangerous. It is not very long-lasting. But most of the things, cotton-based papers we are using, our currency is a cotton-based paper. But most of the other things are in bast-based, these are fiber-based manuscripts are there. And we prepare the manuscripts. Generally, we take the fiber from the plant and we have joined with the sizing material. And we use some loading material to give some softness, is all those things. And we are making the paper by handmade. Because in the world nowadays, the Japanese paper is a very good paper. Even now, we can preserve the Japanese paper for more than 300 years old. And the machine paper also here. And we have used the ink also. We have 2000 years we are having the ink. That Indian ink is called the Indian ink, and another ink is called iron gall ink. That Indian ink is nothing but we prepare that lamp suit. Lamp suit is nothing but we put a castor lamp and we collect the smoke, and with the smoke we use gum acacia and rainwater. And these three things is an Indian ink. And another ink is a permanent for writing letters and the important documents. They have used iron gall ink. It is a gallnut juice, ferrous sulfate, and the same the gum acacia and rainwater they have used for this. This is a paper manuscript. Next. Next, you can please. So the fibers. Next. So most of the manuscripts in our library is in this way only. So the library, we are having the earliest paper manuscripts, 1476. The earliest palm leaf manuscript we are telling is 11th century, because every manuscript in the first leaf or last leaf only we could find that when it was written, when whether it's original or copy, all these things. If you lost the first both the leaf, it is very difficult to find that dating of the manuscripts. Only the dating by the way of every 100 years there is a development of the scribe. According to the script only we can find this. So that was the people are telling there is 11th century, but if this is a dated manuscript around 1476, our Sarfoji, he pilgrims to Benares and to Calcutta, and he purchased that. It's called Bahmadi. Bahmadi is one of the ancient manuscript. So now the library, we are having this manuscripts, more than 300 years old manuscript. It's written in a good condition also. And some of the mechanical damage, the previous day they have done it, now we are doing it. Next. So this is, without knowing us, we are doing some damages only. Next. This also, this is because they have, without knowing, they have pasted the paper and my friend said this, we have lost a lot of things also. Next. So without your book is not properly handled, so we lost the binding also. Next. You can see, even a book here properly, we have to open it. Otherwise, there is a tension in the top, the thread will be lost. So now here we are repairing the wherever the manuscripts, and we put in a proper acid-free board. It's getting from thing, and so because the climatic condition is in a good, and we are storing in a proper way, and proper there is in a way of every year two times we are taking out and cleaning it. So the manuscripts are nowadays in good condition. Next. So the red cloth they have used to binding it. Next. So mostly this cupboard itself 200 years old. It's a good teak wood they use. You could come across the word Bishop Heber. The Bishop Heber was now the Trichy, there is a college is there. But the Bishop Heber was a Calcutta, from Calcutta he was a chief priest in a churches, and he visited every church, and he came to Tanjavur and he stayed as a guest of Sarfoji in 1826. And after that, he went to Trichy and he died there. And his diary, he mentioned that I have seen two libraries in the Tanjavur. I have one is manuscript library and another is a book library, were stored in 10 big cupboards and 10 small cupboards. So these are the big cupboards mentioned by him. Next. In bottom, there is in a Victor Albert Museum. Even most of our manuscripts are in other countries also. But even there we are in a good cotton boxes, we are keeping it. Next. Some of the important manuscripts in those days, they put it in a clay. That is in the temple, there is in a clay jars also they have used to protect the manuscripts. The clay jars are protected for the, because you know there is in a, just we can compare with the pyramid. The pyramid, whatever materials inside the pyramid, no climate changes. So like that they have used this clay jars also. And bottom there is in a bamboo jars also they have used it, bamboo jars for keeping the manuscripts. Next. And skin, the deer skins are used to cover the manuscripts. If you have one or two manuscripts, they are covered with it also. And there is a, not only in Tamil Nadu, there is in North India also, they have a separate place where they, in the temple there is to keep the manuscripts. In Madura, there is a Brindavan, there is a temple called Madan Mohan Temple. The Madan Mohan Temple, there is a separate room, a separate building, the structure is there. It is called Grandha Samadhi. So mostly manuscripts is kept in the manuscripts, the building itself. So you can see it's the pyramid shape. No, the climate will be, even the sunlight will be reflected outside. Next. We have the traditionally, we have all the type of materials of rare things. I don't want to compare. Next. The fumigation, even you can see in fumigation, nowadays everybody, if fumigation means they use the chemical fumigation only. The chemical fumigation is ordinary, but you can see in every house we have a fumigation, just we put the dhub, sambrani, and the dhub we are using. The dhub is nothing but a fumigation. Just it is to atmosphere, there is more moisture and there is some of the spores are there. To kill the spores only, they use dhub on the things only. But in ancient days, they have used this type of indigenous insect repellents. It is neem leaves, neem seed powder, tobacco, camphor, black cumin, sweet flag, and sinex flower. Neem leaves, dried limbs leaves, dried neem leaves, when the tree is with the flower, you take out, you dry it, and keep in the back of the book. No insect will come. And neem seed also, that is, you take the seed powder and put it there. No, it's a bitter taste, no, nothing will become. The tobacco is a good fungicide. You can put it in after rainy season, camphor or tobacco, you keep it in the books section, nothing will become. That black cumin is also, so both purpose you can use. Sweet flag is vasambu, it is called vasambu, and gorobax and this thing. I found in our library, there is in the bottom, every cupboard in the bottom, you could see when we are opening it, you will find that it's in a snake's law. The snake is removing some skin like that. So the portion of the things they put it in the. I do not know what is important. Scientifically, it was not proved. But anyhow, I asked some of the previous things. They told that if we put it in a snake's law, no termite will come. So that is even now I am following them, but I do not know their importance, but it's a tradition I am following it. Next. So that is the reason those days, to control the book lices only, they put the peacock feathers in the book. Peacock feathers have some aromatic nature. So you put it in the edge of the peacock book, the book lices will come. So now there is a lot of things are there. Next. We are using the oil, citronella oil. Citronella oil is one of the extract of citrus grass. We are smearing the book, manuscripts only. It will give flexibility and it will give clarity to the letters. And so this, in the whole world, is the first insect repellent is cedarwood. Cedarwood oil and cedarwood only. Even now, USA mostly, they are not using any naphthalene balls, anything. They are using cedarwood only. Just to put the cedar tree, they put a small pieces only, they kept in there. Every year, they take the ball, again, they have to apply some oil to reuse for the reuse also. We have this, these are the formula we are keeping it in our materials. Sweet flag one part, cinnamon bark one part, black cumin one part, pepper quarter part, and cloves quarter part. These five materials we dry in the powder and we put it to some 5 grams of camphor. So this is, but we should not use a particular thing for continuously. So we have to change it and we have to give cap also. In summer, nothing, no insect will come, no fungus will go. So we have to change before rainy season, near the rainy season, after rainy season, we have to do. Next. So these are some of the fumigation chambers. Next. You know, I am working the Saraswati Mahal Library, it's one of the ancient libraries. It was started by the King Raghunathanayaka. Just because that was, he came to power in 1600 to 1635, and that was a very proper period, there is no war and other thing. So more than 30 poets were there. Whatever they have written was stored in a separate room, which is called Saraswati Bhanda. After that, it was completely captured by the Maratha kings. The great Swaji's brother was the first Maratha king of Tanjavur. And continuously that 11 kings ruled. The last but one was Sarfoj Raja. He came to power in 1798, but only independent king. In 1799, mostly the British captured all over South India. Lost the power, but he has not opposed the British. So he has a treaty between the British, that is the library is existing. So he completely diverted his activities for art and literature. So now this library, we are having 49,000 manuscripts and major for 25,000 in palm leaf and 24,000 in paper form, and that is some of the manuscript you can see. Next. So wherever in those days, wherever you can find any library, it's called Saraswati Bhandar or Saraswati Mahal only, because of this goddess of the abode of goddess. So this is one of the Tanjore painting. The Tanjore painting is one of the important thing. This is a 350 years old Tanjore painting. The body is decorated with gold foil. That is important thing. Next. So this is now the new entrance of Saraswati Mahal Library. Just it's one of that's in the palace itself, Tanjore Palace itself. It is next. So he is the person, Raghunathanayaka. This the image. There is the bronze casting is also famous from Tanjavur only. Most of the bronze, even Michael Sharp shown that Naraja, it was from Tanjavur only, because Tanjore, particularly Swami Malai, it's even now is a lot of images are. Previously it was a temple, but nowadays every house they are decorating this temple. It's in a solid cast, because that is only in North India, mostly it is Kalo cast only. It's a solid cast. Bronze metals are there. Next. He is a person, Sarfoji. he started completely, he diverted because he lost power, so he completely diverted his activities to art and literature, and he prepared more books and manuscripts. And because of in 1824 he was made as one of the member of Royal Asiatic Society, because of that the only four kings were given that opportunity: the King of Orleans, King of Arabia, King of Oud, Lucknow, and King of Thanjavur. Because of that, whatever books printed in London, he received a copy. In that way, he collected more than 5,000 books printed in European language, English, French, and German languages. The earliest printed book of the library is 1692. It's in a map of the world. It's a very ancient map. Next. It's a canvas painting. You can find it, the canvas painting. Just next. We have the manuscripts and Moody documents. Day-to-day diaries were mentioned in that in the Sarfoji, the Maratha period, the day-to-day diaries. We have the good paintings, books, and rare artifacts also, and maps and atlases also. Next. So this is a Palm Leaf manuscript, the picture that is known as Thiruvai Mali Vasakamalai. Mostly Orissa, you could find that most of the manuscripts with the pictorial manuscripts there, but we have the only manuscripts with picture with the Lord Krishna reclining and the serpent with his consort. Next. So we have 49 different, Sanskrit is the richest collection. We are having 39,000 titles, and Tamil 7,000, and Marathi 3,000. And we have a Telugu manuscripts of 1,200. So mostly Sanskrit manuscripts, because as I told you, it's in a Palm Leaf manuscript, any script in circular form only we can write. Any script, for Devanagari script we cannot write in that. So all the South Indian scripts only we can write. Even in the ancient day, they won't put any punctuation mark also. You put a punctuation mark, it penetrated. So that's why there is an ancient writing is entirely different. So it needs some skills. So we are conducting nowadays courses for reading that manuscripts also. Next. So this is a part of the entrance of this. You can see this is one of the part of the palace. It's a high ceiling under the court also. Always the climate is in the same climate. That is the reason the library is last 400 years without disturbing. It's in good condition. And the Maratha, this wooden cupboards also important things. Next. This is all the palm leaf manuscripts we are storing it in. The Sanskrit manuscript and all the palm leaf manuscripts storing in this form only. Next. So this is another way of, new cupboards we have purchased. Next. So we are applying that oil. Because the oil, why? A manuscript, it must have some 15% moisture content. Whenever there is a dam, whenever if a moisture content, it lost moisture content, when we are handling it, will break. To avoid that only, we are smearing that oil. So the oil will, three times, there is once the oil, when we are keeping the oil will give flexibility to the leaves, and also it will give clarity to the letters, and also it's the smell will keep away the insects. So it, since we are having 25,000 manuscripts, a cycle will take 6 years. Once in 6 years, we will do the same thing. Next. So the paper manuscripts. Next. 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 So this is 170 years old cloth, because even nowadays we are preserving some of the cloth designs, because research are coming for the ancient textile designs. So these cloths only they use to wrap the manuscripts with a red and black printing also. So the cloths are very old cloths. Next. Next. So this is the Bahumadi, 1476. It's the oldest paper manuscript of the library. Next. This is a Bengali manuscript. Actually, it was seems to be a palm leaf form, but it's a paper manuscript. Next. We have a good illustrated manuscripts also. Some of the Mahabharata, Ramayana, every chapter has some illustrations. The illustration, most of the illustration you could have that gold foil. This is a Mahabharata war scenes you can find. The chapter, every chapter you could find. This is in the flower designs with the things in the every chapter you can find it. Next. So this is Thiruvayada Purana. This is Madurai Thiruvayada Purana. So the marriage of Lord Shiva and Parvati, there is Meenakshi. You could find the stage dancers with the musicians. It's in a pictorial form. So you can find, these pictures give what are the musical instruments in those days they could use in all these things also. Next. 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 The library have a cataloging system. Sarfoji came. After that, he found there is no proper catalog. So by order of Sarfoji, the first catalog was prepared for palm leaf manuscripts in palm leaf form. That was the thing in 1801. Next. 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 We have a hospital there, and the Sarfoji maintained the caste history seats of that. day to day, this is the patient's name, what were the treatment given, all the information. So that was maintained by British doctors. This was, you can see this in September 1827. It's the name of the disease is there. Then Kuppanna, age 50, and the admission, and what are the treatment given. And lastly, discharged quite well with the enam of 2 rupees. They have not collected any material amount from the patient. They give 2 rupees to the patient name. But bottom, you can find, in presence of His Highness. This operation was given in presence of His Highness. Next. Next. We have the identical dictionary for the plants also. So this was used with the natural colors they have used for drawing things. Next. You can see the pigments from the plant-based pigments. Next. Next. Not only human medicine, he was animal medicine also. We have the Gajasasra. In those days, the Gajasasra, signs of elephants they have drawn. That mythologically, that they have some wings are there, later it was lost it. And it was based on the back part completely, treatment, disease treatment, and practice, everything they have done. Next. How to capture the wild elephants like that. Next. It's Asusasra. It's a science of horses, different type of horses, characters and everything. So next. Next. Sitra Ramayana. Ramayana in pictorial form. There is this Balaganda. It's the birth of Ramayana to marriage. You can find every things in a small frame, and they have given Telugu description in the black line also. In such a, next. So this is 300 years old, Nayaki Nayaka Baba. You can find it in costumes, ornaments, and all the other things also. Next. It's accessible for small children to give this Nidhisastra stories. They have make a manuscript. It's an accessible with the pictures also. Next. It's a Modi document, day-to-day diary, correspondence, temples, whatever the amount given. And just only one information I want to say. Now, Karaikal is the middle of Tamil Nadu. How it went there? Because Karaikal and that 51 village around Karaikal was, that is one of the king, Pradabhishma was mortgaged to French and get amount. But his son was along with the British. He has not returned the amount, so it was under Pondicherry control. So that type of information we are getting from this Modi documents. Next. It's a pet bed of Sarfoji. So he practiced this falcon to intercept the message. Those days send the message through the doves, pigeons. So this falcon will intercept the message. Next. So this is one of the view of Christopher Bathingers in Banaras. Next. Next. This is the books also. Next. Next. So this is one of some of the, we are having some rare books of like this. All the books are, it's Voyages of Valencia. It gives some of the important things of Saraswati Mahalaya Brindi and Sarfoji and other places in Tamil Nadu also. Next. This is another interesting, that's just, it's a physiognomy charts. Charles Lebrun, a French artist, he compared human face with the beast and bat's face once. If anybody has a resemblance of that animal, they should have the character of the animal. That was his theory. Next. So this was the map mentioned by our Michael. Actually, this is a Daniel map, sorry, Renal map. You could find there is two things only this map given. If it's a Carnatic missing, most of the people, they are thinking that Karnataka and Carnatic missing. Actually, that area from Tanjavur to Ongol, that calls is Carnatic. The area itself is Carnatic. So the music forested area is called Carnatic. And if you ask somebody what is Coromandel, nobody knows. But it's actually Rajaraja's son, Rajendra Chola, he won up to Ganges. So the whole area was called as Chola Mandalam. The Portuguese could not pronounce the word Cholamandalam, become Choramandal, then Coromandel. Coromandel is nothing but Cholamandalam. And there was a bridge between the Sloan and the India. It's called Adams Bridge. The Adams Bridge is still there because NASA has taken a photograph. It is 11 feet under the water only. Next. So these are some of the things I want to share with you. Thank you for this.
Yes. Due to lack of time, we'll have just two questions, and the rest of the questions you can ask afterwards.
It was a very enlightening experience to listen to you. How many manuscripts which are there in the library have been published? I said 49,000 manuscripts are there.
It's an interesting question, but actually, we have started the publication work from 1948 onwards. Because the lack of the experts from there, we are the publication things are very slow. But most of our publications through the literature, through research from other university students are doing it and publishing it. So by that way, now we have a approximate calculation that is among this 49,000, at least some 5,000 to be published, 5,000 manuscripts to be published. But it is still it is going on.
My question was slightly different. Has the Saraswati Mahal Library started digitizing some of the manuscripts?
Digitalization came a little late, because we are not aware of the much information of that things. So in 1979 onwards, we are doing microfilming. Just because, so still we are having, wherever I go, I tell, if you write in a palm leaf, you can preserve, certainly you can preserve 500 years. If you write in a paper, handmade paper, certainly you can preserve 300 years. If you can microfilm, certainly you can preserve 200 years. Still, there is a controversy of how long we can preserve a digital CD or a DVD or in that form. Because it is in a changing of thing. If something is now I have digitalized, I cannot read it after 10 years because changing of the checking. Unless I may be accommodated every changes to my pictures, my material. Then only I have to go along with the changes of the computer. If I digitalize, I kept for sometimes after 5 years I am doing it certainly. And also there is the CD. Previously there was an aluminium foil only. That was in the edges. If anything damages, it was not read. But nowadays only the US has brought out in a gold foil CD. It is an archival CD. It may be some 100 years come. It is yet to decide. But anyhow, we have started our books only. The digitalization of our publication, we have started. But slowly it will go. And we want to make it at least another 5 years. Most of the things must be in the web. That is our aim. That, but we have lack of the technical things only. Yeah.
Okay.
Can you give it in English, that is a translation of that slogan?
Yes, sir, that the manuscript say, save me from the water, save me from the oil.
Okay.
Rakshamang Shlathavandha, save me from the loose tying, akubhya from the rats, and paravastava, don't give me to the other, another hand.
Okay.
Iti badati pustakam. That is the manuscript says.
Yeah.
If you say that ginger oil, based on one legend,
the
ginger oil is the preservative for the manuscript. Yeah. Why everything we get in the manuscript?
Yeah, you are correct. But it's what we are using is not an oil, it is an extraction.
No, sir, I am not telling of that lemongrass oil and oil.
It's a lemongrass oil.
You talked about ginger oil.
Yeah, that may be the reference I got it. Because the reference they have got it, maybe the early stage that must be the available thing. So mostly the ginger was, even you know that it's an achola, that's a manu, manumurikanda soil, and that thing they have mentioned, they have used tilka tail, tilat thailamitte, they have used tilat elements, means this tilka
tail.
Yeah, ginger oil, they have used it. Because that is our reference, but now we are not using nowadays, but we got the reference of the ancient days. Yeah. Because only thing is the fatty, the edible oils, we should not use for manuscripts. Anything, it's a volatile, it's an insect repellent oils only. We have lemongrass oil and citron oil, camphor oil. All these things are a little volatile, and also it insect repellent quality. This is how they, I can use it.
One idea: this next log they are putting under the almirage of the manuscript. Maybe to frighten the rats.
Maybe. Because so it is not scientifically proved, so I am following the same practices only. I could not find, but other things I find, I have discussed these things for other people also, but they not give proper answer for these things. But I have not left it. I am using that thing.
The manuscript catalog prepared in the manuscript family form.
Yeah.
Family catalogs are prepared. Whether it has been published?
No, it is not published. Because already we have other form, because it is 1801, so we, even if we publish, it is not only it is an information, because through the catalog we cannot get any manuscripts from our manuscripts.
But that is the way we can train our student that our manuscript catalog was even existing in the 1801.
Yeah, that may be some of the portion may be put it in a web and other things also. We may brought out some articles of that manuscripts and what is what are the information they have, what are the field they have covered in those days, and all the informations they have, we have put it in a just in a article form only.
There
we
is
are not
no,
it is not for idea is if possible if possible
yes,
because sir, in Telugu manuscripts it is written in Telugu,
but
is,
we will for India. Has no importance so far the text is concerned.
Certainly, then I'll take your advice. So,
you.
Some of the at least some important leaves must be we can scan it and put it in the web for sake of the others. I will do that thing.
Thank you. Sir.
Thank you.